Bunker is brought to you by Empire Paintball, AirUps Bunkers, Tippmann and GI Sports, Patchworks, Velkin Sports, DLX, manufacturer of the Lux Paintball Marker.
Hey guys, and welcome to Behind the Bunker here, episode 161 at beautiful Wellington Street Studios. The weather is nice today. If we weren't in here, we'd be sitting on the patio. So thank you very much for joining us. This is episode 161. Stay tuned just after the show for our podcast number 22. We'll be getting to that shortly. So that all starts in about 25 minutes. Tonight we're going to be talking about, for each event that you go to, do you change your gear or do you always have the exact same setup? We have a winner we're going to announce tonight for our last Living Legends giveaway. So if you entered it over the last couple weeks, your name's going to be in the draw. We've already drawn it. I already know who the winner is, but we'll tell you in a few moments. We have Tech Watch tonight. We have a couple great things. We have a bonus ball segment. We have Bowtie Bandits back for another gaming edition. And Danger Man. Yeah. With me tonight, I have my friend Josh Zubizabrickus.
Good evening, everybody at home. Why can't I hear myself? My mic on, Seb?
It is.
Seb. Oh, there it is.
Seb.
Okay.
Seb.
Seb. Seb 1, Seb 2. All right. Yeah, welcome. Stay tuned later on the show for Paintball Around the World, where we bring you the posters for the games that are coming to a field near you. We have plenty of banter that's coming up and probably just a small amount of shenanigans for the next hour and a half.
Some token shenanigans?
Yeah.
Good evening, I'm Joe Kimson from Flaggarters Paintball, and tonight you'll be watching a segment from the vault where we go back in history, back in the early days of paintball. You'll also be watching a custom corner segment where you, the viewer, send in your submissions of things you've modified, customized, tricked out in the world of paintball. Maybe even something of yours. So anyway, guys, stay tuned for Behind the Bunker, and we'll go pew.
Very nice. You see that? Right in the bucket.
Awesome. Toss.
So with us tonight in our production booth. Now, if you guys were watching last week, you know how much of an abomination of a show it was because I was not on the panel. I was actually manning the booth because Seb was off.
Seb.
Matt was off. Seb. And Dusty was off, all sick and having work commitments. So guess who's back in the studio? We have Seb.
All of them.
And Matt.
Hello and welcome.
Very good. And then we have Dustin Schnitzelholst back.
Yeah.
I like your corner.
Thanks.
Dusty's corner. Now. You've got an artwork.
You can't quite see the line growing out of my head anymore.
No.
You look little.
I feel little.
Little. Littler.
Yeah, we can't see the line growing out of your head, but we can still see your tail.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, guys, there is no excuse for any screw-ups in the production booth tonight.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. Uh-oh. So no pressure.
I think that bottle of 40 Creek over there might have something to say.
40 Creek. No. Sub.
So lots to get to on the show tonight, guys. First of all, I want to announce, I won't hold it any longer, the last ticket winner for Living Legends, you get two cases of paint. You get, not even close.
I didn't want to hit the light. Oh, it's a weird angle.
Seb just tried to throw. Okay, Joe got one. There we go. All right, so
I
the
wasn't
winner
even looking.
Of Living Legends passed.
Did you hear that? He just called me Seb.
Seb.
Could have been worse.
Something just happened. Some sound action.
It must be because we're wearing matching awesome t-shirts.
I keep sound on sound action.
I didn't even notice that. If you guys wouldn't have said anything, I wouldn't have saw
you're
that.
You're tight and be ready in 2 minutes.
Who's wearing a matching t-shirt?
And you notice this picture on picture? Matt's really
me
showing
off
tonight.
Me and the lovely talented Zuby.
Booze
like,
and
see,
fall.
You can't, you couldn't,
we coordinated wardrobe.
Week.
Yeah. Let's all talk over each other.
Can we?
Yeah. On 3, 2, 1, go.
Okay. So you know what? Nobody cares. Let's give away this win.
Really
announce the winner.
Today.
So, guys, we're giving away a Living Legends pass for two cases of paint, free air ticket. And,
you misspelled winner. It says wiener.
Yeah, but I drew an arrow towards you to see that. So, guys, the winner is
back.
Dan Wanker. Woodstra.
Whoa, Dan.
No, sorry, Wood Raska.
Dan
Wood Raska.
Dan.
Yeah. Right off his chair.
So Dan Rudwaska, get a hold of me, and I will send you out some tickets. Now, tonight, guys, we still have lots to get to on the show, so don't go anywhere. As I say, the podcast we're going to be filming or recording a little bit later on as well. Casting call, guys. If you would like to be a part of this abomination we call a paintball show every week, all you need to do is send us in an email with your general questions, your team bios, your custom gear picks, your event posters, or nominate someone for player of the week.
Week.
Guys, follow us on YouTube. Subscribe to us so that you don't miss any of our shows or any of our feature videos that we do. Follow us on iTunes, and you'll get our podcast, or Podomatic if you're on an Android. Check us out on Instagram, and dial us up on Skype. We're going to start taking some Skype calls in the podcast. We keep saying that, but we get overwhelmed with questions, and we just continue to ramble so that we never get any of your calls in, but we will. Tech Watch this week, guys. Tech Watch. A couple things I want to tell you. Joe, we were at Extravaganza this past year, but the year before, where they released the Tiberius T15.
I wasn't there either. But don't worry about it.
I'm single-handedly ignoring Josh all tonight because, I don't know. I'm just ignoring
him. Because I parked in your spot?
Really?
Yeah, it signed clearly said management, so I don't know. So we were there at Paintball Extravaganza.
Also said for expecting mothers, but I parked there anyways.
Well, I might be expecting a mother someday. So we were at Paintball Extravaganza a couple years ago, and Tiberius T15.
Yes, I remember.
Released the information that they're going to go off. But what they didn't show was the mag. Remember they were talking about the mag and how they wouldn't let us see the inside because it was
19 round true free mag. I think
it was going to revolutionize the industry. Well, Matt, let's play the video so I can show Joe. This was released this week. You can see that's a first strike round that's in it right now.
Oh yeah. So
you'll see what it does when you load it. Face in, it turn around, and it faces it forward.
Huh.
Now, is that innovative? Is that... I don't know. I think it's very
Assault creative. With a deadly weapon.
Yeah, congratulations. You innovated one of the worst designs in paintball. The first strike round. So stupid.
Zuby doesn't like first strike rounds.
Tell us how you really felt about it, Zuby.
But that's it. That's the inside of that mag that we couldn't see last year.
So I thought you were going to impress me with the inside of the strike loader.
No. No, my 3D printer's still on the fritz for that one. Also, Matt, I'm going to load up here if I can find it. These pictures were sent in to us, if you want to go over to my computer for a second.
Okay.
These are just some quick pictures that J4 Paintball sent in. You can see that they now have all of their parts laying out on a table, and they're starting to assemble guns. Last I heard, they
nice
were
carpet.
They matched their drapes. If in one of the pictures, I can't
I like
see
that.
But you can see they have all their stuff laid out, and they're building as fast as they can. So I'm not sure when we're going to see them on the market, but if they've got all the parts and they're doing their final testing, you should see them soon. But that's what it looks like all together. This one here, I have to say, is my favorite. I like the black on the green.
I like the black on green.
Yeah. And then
here. A little bit of Mars action.
Here, if I can read it. This shows the coverage of the hydrophilic coating on the boards and make sure that...
hydrophobic.
Hydrophobic.
What do you got on your mind? Hydrophilic.
I had some wine.
You've been Googling some stuff before you got here or what?
So make sure that the boards are basically waterproof. But isn't that cool? It says something you don't typically see every day. Very cool. So thank you for J4 for sending that in, and hopefully we'll see more of their guns coming up, hopefully on the market very soon. I'd like to get one in my hand and actually shoot them.
What is it called?
So
the J4 what?
Torque.
Torque.
The Torque. Not to be confused with the Twerk. Now, Joe.
Yes.
Again this week, you have a record number of submissions for Custom Corner. So many that if you've sent stuff in and you haven't seen it on the show yet, it's probably in queue, so you'll see it in the next week or two. But I email anybody that I put their picture up. I let them know that it's going to be on the show. So why don't we get into Joe's
Custom Corner. Custom Corner.
Brought to you by Patchworks.
Yeah, thanks. Custom Corner is sponsored by Patchwork. So if you've got some custom patches, a team or several teams that you're on, get Patchworks to make them, design them, and ship them to you. So we've got four patches today. Heroes don't wear capes. They wear dog tags. That looks like the umbrella sign for the Umbrella Corporation. And the engine operator.
Nice.
The E200. Nice.
And this is limited edition.
Limited edition. Gold. Gold Kachak.
Wow, chica, wow, wow.
I got nothing.
Nice.
Got nothing.
That's what she said.
All right, and our first submission comes to us from Jordan Nickel. This is his Airgun Designs brass body gold paint
very
with a Crossman
pretty.
Stock modded to fit the grip. So anyone that's been in paintball for a long time may have seen one of these Crossman stocks on a PGP or something like that. This is pretty old school. Nicely done, Jordan Nickel. And our second image comes to us from Brent Hill. Please show. I watch your videos. I just wanted to share my custom masks I made. I really appreciate it. Thanks. And it looks like a pair of Scott goggles. Pretty cool. And he's turned that into an assault sort of style mask with a gas mask. Coming to us from Lenny Negron is his custom Sly goggle with some zombie attachments to not let them get too close. You wouldn't want a French kiss him with his mask on, but he could videotape it for sure.
Hey, French awesome. Kissing is fun.
And this comes to us from Walk On PB. We don't have his name, but he's a single submit to you. This, as the sun went down, I'll have to wait till the sun comes up to take pictures of my gear. So it looks like it's a customized, modified, tricked out rear air fed something. I can't see from here. Chris Havoc Pringles custom I-4 from Team Vindex. These guys don't make Windex, they make Vindex. That's the Russian version.
I see someone taking a selfie.
Selfie image. There we go. And Phantom Regiment has sent, hey there, BTB crew. Wanted to share with our custom team dog tags and 12-gram bandoliers made by Paracord Addiction. This is a great family-owned small business of making rounds in the Southeast. Our tags look great. My bandolier is rock solid. If any viewers wanted to get something like this, Phantom Regiment has nothing but great things to say about them.
Your bandolier's awesome. Rock solid. That's pretty something to be proud of.
Yeah, nothing like a rock solid. This one is from Joe Cabrera with his RL MacDev. And it looks
that's
like his
cool.
It's customized, low-gunized, and he's got some sort of looks like a tattoo that
I think
matches,
it matches
a shooter.
His tattoo. Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Good for you. Darren Kuhl has sent in his modified customized TPX.
Yes.
This is a rear feed. Yes. It's got a remote line adapter and a mag fed, and it's held on with electrical tape in case some of the electronics in his TPX goes down. He's also
got
an apex
short.
Barrel on it. You don't want to do that. Keep the batteries warm.
And remember, folks, if the women don't find you handsome, they should at least find you handy.
I thought that was duct tape.
Jared Richty.
Whatever.
Jared Richty, love God, love others, letting God leave. He has a custom Tiberius T.8 with cryptic typhoon tape call sign compensator Apex wanting to get some mag-fed guns on your show.
I believe awesome. I've met him, actually.
Very nicely done.
Oh.
Ooh, Graham Sweens is of North Carolina. Oh, here are my submissions
volts.
For Custom Corner. The first picture is my sniper bunk that he traded a Phantom for. It has a WGP slider trigger frame, a CCM regulator, a CPASA, and a GAT pump kit. The second picture is his ProFlexes
cool
with a lens sticker done by Hold Fast Stickers. Let's nicely see. Done.
Lady Killer? Lady
Killer? Lady Killer. I don't know.
Lady Killer.
Kill.
Here's
Hold
something.
Fast Stickers is... Oh, I can't think of her name right
the
now.
The sticker people.
Yeah.
And here's
she did
something
some
for
us, actually.
Here's our next one. Here's something for Custom Corner.
Margie Clark. That's
it's
her name.
From she's Whoa. In Oregon or somewhere. This is from the Tippmann World Challenge last year at Hell Survivors. I didn't get the name of the owner, but it's still a nice mod. So thank you very much for this submission. That's pretty
What's
awesome.
It's got on the end of his barrel.
It's a barrel bag. Oh, I don't know, some sort of rail interface thing. Maybe it's a pump gun.
Looks like
Josh.
It's an Apex barrel.
With a
or
rail
a homemade
on.
Silencer. Who knows? Maybe that's what his homemade silencer with a rail.
But whatever it is, the skull's going to take a bite out of it.
skull diggery.
Our next submission comes to us from Robert Graves. It's a mini in an ETHA EMC kit. Look at that.
Yeah. That's definitely modified.
It's modified. It looks pretty good. And he's got a stock on it and a spire.
I saw this one ahead of
He's
time.
He's an aspiring young shooter.
Oh, this guy Ooh. Gets a clap
oh,
for sure.
Mama.
Paul Pazdernick.
Yum.
Hi, I'm Paul from Houston. We'll assume it's Texas. This is my first gun he bought in 2002. It's a half black 2K body done by me. He did this himself. And the next one is an E2 frame with a Noida Tadeo Yazuo board, break beam eyes, STLPR, an Eclipse Nexus RAM, NQEVs, pure Bolt 4 modified, pure energy Pops ASA, aka 2 liter, Madman Springs, Freak or Deadly Wind waiting on a Stella. Stella, because they're interstellar.
Giddy up.
Our next one comes to us from David Valdoff, also a Russian from New Jersey. This is his customized paintball license plate. Nicely done. I think we should have a segment. If you have license plates that have anything to do with paintball, send those in and we'll do plates for players. Plates for paintball. And our final submission comes from Michael Simpson. This is his wall of paintballs that he's kept from the different games he's played at. So,
great idea.
If I honestly did that for however many times we've played, can you imagine how big your thing would be?
It would be.
I have no room on my basement wall.
That's great.
No kidding. So it's pretty cool. It's a good idea.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for your submission. I think that's cool.
Very cool.
So, guys, if you have anything you've modified, customized, tricked out in your paintball arsenal that you're working on, send your submissions to show@behindthebunker.com, and we will put them on. Please tell us who you are, where you're from, and so we have a little bit about you.
Aside from tanking, another important role is DPS. DPS are the people getting the eliminations. And while this might be the most obvious and popular, it's just as important as any other role.
Absolutely. Essentially, elimination is the name of the game. And there's many ways you can get this done.
One way to get this done is by flanking. Remember when you were gaming and you took that roundabout path that put you behind enemy lines and you got to wipe out the entire enemy team? Well, look for those opportunities out on the paintball field. They're just as effective.
While playing first-person shooters, we've all had those situations where this one person in a room with a shotgun or a sniper will just be tearing your team apart. And sometimes you just gotta get in there and make the trade just to get them off your back. Well, same thing holds true for paintball. Don't be afraid to put yourself out there, make the trade, and get the guy out of a key position so your team can move up the field. Remember, some days you're the bishop, other days you're just the pawn.
A less known method is crossing up. It's much easier to shoot the guy at an angle than it is to shoot the guy right in front of you who has full cover.
Like we said, this one's probably a little more obvious, but there it is all summed up. Maybe pick something up.
I hope these tips help, and watch for more to come.
Until next time, we're the Bowtie Bandits.
All right, very good. And that was another segment from the Bowtie Bandits, guys. They take those of you that play games, which is pretty much everybody, and tells you about how you can take those game skills into paintball. So we're going to hopefully see more of those over the next couple of weeks. And we've had really good success on those. People really enjoy those. So thank you very much, Bowtie Bandits. Up next, we have Seb with his segment.
Bonus Ball is brought to you by DLX, manufacturer of the Mighty Fine Lux.
Can you do pew pew pew, Joe, in like serious ramping mode?
Pew 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 pew.
Yeah. Plus pew pew.
Yeah, that's only 10.5 though.
Okay. I can go faster. I didn't want to over. Someone want? Are you talking?
I am talking.
I believe it's a segment.
Well, I was being polite.
That's
yeah, so
French-like.
Yeah, bonus ball. Let's talk about some speedball stuff. Last weekend, Millennium event in Europe. I'm not sure if we can switch to Todd's Computron 2000.
There we go. Look at that.
Yeah, so that's the field you're seeing that these guys were playing on last week. Pretty
it's
interesting.
It's really green in France.
It is very green in France. So that
I guess it's
vert.
It wasn't very busy. The stadium's empty.
Vire.
Yeah.
Last weekend, our Mighty Fan Canadians and Minton Impact pulled off a solid win against Houston Heat in the first Millennium event in Puget-sur-Argent in the south of France. Sina Asmuda, sorry if I butchered your name, which I'm pretty sure I did.
Was I'm pretty sure he did too.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Pretty sure you butcher everything you say. Let's be honest. That's true.
All right, Joe's muted. There you go. Have fun, Joe. No. So yeah, Cena as Muda was on hand to film Impact's first win of the season. So there's going to be some great footage, which is actually already up on the YouTubes. So as far as standings, the favorites being our Chaos or the Tauntauns, both stumbled and failed to make the top four teams of the event. So in first place, Edmonton Impact. In second place, GI Houston Heat. In third place, Outrage Valence. In fourth place, Offenburg coming at you.
That's two events. That's Dallas and then this one that just disappointments.
One thing I'd like to point out, actually, is most of the GI Sports sponsored team.
Didn't your mother ever tell you it's rude to point?
I'm not pointing. I'm
okay.
Gesturing.
Waving.
Waving. Thanks, Dusty. Yeah, so most of the GI sponsored teams are doing very well, actually, whether it's the PSP circuit or the Millennium. So what does that tell us, I wonder? And I ask you, mighty fine viewers,
good coaching.
What do you think? Let us know in the chat room.
Yeah.
Also, we did have new maps released from the PSP. You're going to have to switch to Todd's computer.
Yeah, on I have her loaded up.
There you go. Look at that snake.
Oops.
Isn't that something? Yeah, it's a pretty interesting snake.
Carpet.
Yeah. Can I point something out, though? This field has a much better Dorito side. Look at the Dorito side on this.
Mm-hmm.
And then you go back here and you look at the Millennium. Look at how they have it all. I'm doing some Madden stuff here. All the Doritos are all lined up.
Around the left side of the field.
Well, Todd, if I could point out, the Europeans are known for their architecture and stunning artistry, so I'm sure there has something to do with the design.
Yeah. So well done. But anyway, sorry. And this snake you're saying is going to be pretty,
yeah,
pretty
cool. Yeah, it's really broken apart, and looks like there's going to be some crazy angles going there. So I'll be curious to see what team doing.
Yeah.
There you go.
And this will be held at OXCC, one of our favorite fields in Chesapeake
area.
Yeah,
OXCC.
Yeah.
You know,
so did you mute me?
No.
I did. Briefly.
Are you unmuted?
Because you kept going. So, yeah. There you go. Poo on you. I'm done.
All right. Good. Married you.
Very good. Seb, if you're looking, if I want to find some video footage of the last Millennium series, is there anything you'd recommend, any good videos to check out?
Absolutely, on YouTube, and you can go to PB Nation for the... So this gentleman here, this Cena Asmu, butchered name, actually is the guy that really films and follows around Impact this season for the miniseries on the site. So check it out definitely on PB Nation and or YouTube, and that's very good quality, actually. Full.
Well, you can see right there, the video's high def, and it keeps you interested. So check it out. That's one. Now, is it one for one?
One for one.
Very nice. Cool. Well, thank you very much for another episode of Bonus Ball here, guys. If you have any speedball tournaments or content that you'd like to send into the show, send it to show@behindthebunker.com. So, guys, this week we're talking about, do you adjust your gear? Every time that you play, do you use different gear? Thank you. I didn't know where to take that. Just your gear every time that you play for every event, or do you have the same kit and deal with that every week? You guys have always, as always, sent in your replies on Facebook, and there is a lot of them again tonight. I want to start with Pyro Joe Core says that I use the same gear every time, I'm poor. There is a lot of you out there that have one set of equipment that again go with the same gear. Sean Junkins says the same thing, always the same gear. Hunter Levy says train like you fight, same gear every time. Now I actually agree with that. Although I do modify mine, I play pump when I play recreational, and when I play speedball, obviously I don't use a pump gun, but I do use the same markers all the time. So I agree with you on that one, Sean. Anyone have anything else or Hunter rather?
Yeah, Matt Sidoti writes in, sometimes I use my bare hands. Allow me to quickly verify the fact that you have a beard, and we'll send your man card in the mail right away.
Good for him.
Ron Sanchez says, depends on the field and my role and what I feel like using.
It's Rob Dirty.
And then he lists a buttload, and I mean a buttload, tractor trailer full, cat carrier full of mag-fed stuff. So it's not real paintball, so it doesn't count.
Jesus.
I am. Well,
Aaron Black says, different setup every game. That's the advantage of a mall system and mag-fed.
Michael Pinternick says, I technically have three different setups depending on the marker type for the MagFed play. I have both a Vietnam, he put an acronym, but I'll say Long Range Reconnaissance Patrol, Military Assistance Command, Vietnam Special Operations Group gear. Haha. Ah, more modern gear stuff. He wears multicam, then he switches up for different things. He's got a plate carrier. So he switches it up depending on what he's going to play, who he's going to be, what era, what year, what decade, what war, what battle he's going to. Yep. Actually, Vietnam was a police action. It wasn't a war. Dan Ball, depends on the field and event, much like what Josh said. People have different gear for different occasions, just like women have different purses for different events. So
different moods
switch
for
it
every
up.
Minute. Sorry?
Black goes with everything, and you can dress it up with pearls. Hoo-yah.
Very good. Do you have any more, Josh?
Josh Booth changes his BDUs as per the environment.
Mm.
Oh, that's a good one. Joe Marshall does it per time of day.
Marshall says he changes 2 or 3 times per day.
As the sun changes, he may get different shadows, so he'll change his camouflage slightly.
James Lucas, for me, sums it up. He says, always the same gear with minor swaps for woods, speedball, or backyard. Although I don't play my backyard, but for speedball versus woods ball, as Joe likes it, I that's it. It goes from semi-auto to pump.
Did you say woods ball?
I said woods ball, woods ball, woods ball. Joe's favorite format, where Zuby's is hyper ball.
Yep.
All right,
long
guys.
Live
so
the black tubes.
Next week we're going to be talking about why do you attend the fields or the events that you do? What causes you to go to the same fields or the same events every year? What do you look forward to? So send that in to showitbehindthebunker.com or check us out on Facebook. That's where a lot of people do their responses as well. So tonight we have a Danger Man event video as well as tons of posters for paintball around the world.
Danger Man.
Brought to you by Falcon Sports.
Dude. It's my segment all the time. Or all of the times. Did I say it right, Seb?
All of a sudden.
All of the times?
Yes,
all
you
of a
did.
Suddens.
All of the
you
times did. Out on
to
the
speak,
internet.
To speak French, you have to pluralize everything.
I'm about to mute the whole goddamn room tonight.
Take
Come
it easy.
On.
I was
it's
going to
be a pretty quiet
right.
show then.
That's enoughs.
That was quiet.
That's awesome.
Go on, Zubies.
Awesome.
That's enoughs. Enoughs.
I forgives you.
Yeah, welcome to Paintball Around the World. We're bringing the posters.
Thanks for having
for
us.
The games that are coming to a field near you. If you have one in, send it on in to show@behindthebunker.com, and Todd will be sure to get it up on the next show. There we go.
Oh, Zuby.
The first one up for this evening is Oklahoma D-Day. That's June 9th through till 14th.
It's a long game.
Yeah. And Day of Redemption is coming up Sunday. And I can't read it because it's right smack dab in white lettering on the flash. And the, what does
27th,
that say?
April 27th.
Yeah?
Yeah.
How do you not need glasses with this laptop you have?
I have it set to fuzzy for my my eyes.
And Shoreline, you can be the one. That can be only one. And September 20th and 21st, of course, that's at Flag Riders. That's Shoreline's first venture into the North Americas.
I hear there's going to be more information in the next 2 weeks.
Some there should be.
Information.
But all you need to know is I will be one. There and I will be playing.
One.
I don't know what side.
Josh is
for,
the one.
But I am the one.
I'll be there with my Titan.
One.
And the Titan?
Yeah. Will you be there with your Titan?
Oh, yeah.
With the Ogre?
Yeah. Nice. The Ogre and the chain gun.
Nice.
Yeah, buddy. June 7th, OXCC's classic Red versus Blue is coming back, and I doubt Todd will be there dressed that warmly.
Nope.
However, if you do need directions for the closest hospital and where to hang the flag station, Todd
oh,
will
Christ.
Put that out for you. Blues Crew has posted up their schedule of carnage for 2014. If you wish to join Blues Crew and their carnage-causing tour, stop on by their website and sign up for any one of those games listed.
I wish they would have called it Schedule O Carnage. Just has a better ring to
or
it.
Or scheduled day carnage. Yeah, yes. It could be French.
Carnage.
All-Canadian defense led by Darren Hellcat is taking place at Castle Conquest on September 27th through till 28th. That's the weekend after Shoreline's event. So you can just stop by Shoreline and head on down to EMR.
Very nice.
Sport Tomcat Cunningham and his gold catchack batches at GRC's paintball.
Tick.
24 game Tick. On June 7th.
Very cool.
And 8th.
Ding, ding.
Nice. And the game that's ding, already ding, won ding. Before it was even played. Star Trek is Trek Wars. Darth Vader's already won, so don't even bother coming if you're playing for the...
Live long and prosper.
What?
Live long what? And prosper.
Ooh, a new poster.
What? Oh, Fallout.
I wasn't even done saying the date from the other one, and you already switched it.
Sunday, April 27th.
That's thank you, Joe.
You said it was whoa. Already won.
Welcome, whoa. Josh.
Thank you, Joe.
It's a joint effort.
You could just come out and we'll shoot some tasers for a little while. It'll be fun. Well, yeah, and then Grim City Sports presents Fallout March of the Legion. That's July 19th through 20th at Fort Knox Paintball. See, Fort Knox knows how to put out a poster.
Yes, they do.
Nice big letters. They got the who, the what, the where, the why, the when, and the BTB logo.
Most important.
Are they in Kentucky?
Kentucky.
Huh? I don't know. Sorry.
Saturday, June 7th. Bloom. It's flowers versus zombies.
Photosynthesis.
I Googled sounds for photosynthesis when you? I got home after the show last week, and nothing came up.
No, I bet not.
No, and Grim City, mischief starch. And monsters.
Starch.
I don't even know what the... Why do you make a noise for mischief?
Mischief versus... Yeah.
I don't know. But that one's October 25th.
Eggs breaking against your house.
Here's a good idea. Why not stop by the game, ask, and then report back?
Ah.
Yeah. Hmm. And Payroll is putting on the Terminator Human Revolution game September 13th through the 14th, and that's at Landing Zone Paintball. And Silva presents Operation Linebacker September 13th.
Charlie can't see him or hear him.
Skirmish. And Fields of Fire Mystic continues their silliness of baseball games. That's Boston Red Sox versus New York Yankees. I'm sorry. Yo, when I was a kid, I'd come home from school and I'd be like all excited because the Simpsons were on. Turn on. Nope. The Yankees are playing. Thanks, Fox. Mm. You suck. And Doctor Strange Love or How I Learned to Stop Worrying and Love the Bomb. Stop on in. Help out our good friend Eric Engler as General Jack D. Ripper. Yeah.
I laugh at that every week.
Yeah. Ha 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 ha. And April 20th, Time Wars 2 Apocalypse Nam. And no word on whether or not the guy that's in the poster is going to be there or not.
I hope not. He looks very scary.
Or whether he's been to the dentist yet.
Very
dude,
good.
Dude needs some caps on those things. You're never going to find a woman like that. Seriously. Go to the dentist.
Really?
It's disturbing.
Yeah. Floss.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can all floss right. with a stick.
So if you guys, I got to stop him from ranting. If you guys would like to send in your poster,
thank
send
you.
It to show@behindthebunker.com and make sure the Behind the Bunker logo is on it.
I thought there was a video.
Is there a video?
Oh, yes. There's one from Danger Man.
Danger Man.
Thanks, Matt.
It's in
Danger
our
Man.
That's why I was.
We haven't had Danger Man on in a couple weeks because he's been off for a little bit, but he is back now, and he's going to be at an event. Why don't we let him tell you?
Hey, guys. This is Danger Man. I'm sporting my new Bob Long Insight 2014. And this month, April 26th and 27th, 2014 or 2014, I'm going to be at EMR Paintball in New Milford, PA. If you're not familiar with the location, Mike from Blues Crew owns that. And essentially, what I'd like you to do is pre-register for the event. Obviously, you'll get discounts by doing so. But in your comments, put Danger Man sent me. This way, we'll know who I brought along for the ride. You can play with me or play against me. I'm probably going to flip, play attack one day and defend the other. Can't tell you which one right now. Don't want to spoil the fun. In the meantime, here's something in it for you. If you come to this event, all you have to do is get my attention in the game or between games. I'm not going to keep this whole roll, but I got these tickets here, and I'll keep plenty with me. All you do is get my attention, tell me you want to enter, and you can win this Sly Prophet mask that I'm wearing. So, at the end of the event, I'll draw, and maybe you'll be the one. In the meantime, think about it. I want you to come out, either play with me or play against me. Let's do it. April 26th, 27th of this month. Hope to see you there.
Talk about it.
Team feature is brought to you by the fact that I just realized in the beginning words of that intro, it says, if you're on a team where you think you are, I've never seen that before.
I've been on teams where I've had people that tell people that they're on our team, and we may at one point in time said, why don't you come out and try out, or at least come out and being polite, but next thing you know, he's telling his friends that he belongs to our team. So whatever.
Is that what you did? You sidled right on in?
That's it. And, then, when they finally, you know, they just kept hearing my name all the time, like Costanza, and they finally just adopted it. So.
Yes, and team feature today is brought to you by the good people at Empire.
Pew, pew.
They're bringing you the atrocity in which you're about to receive. sent in from Keith Burnett. This is... awesome. He forgot to add in the co-founder and captain of the team is Matt Fitzpatrick and Skyler Rupp.
Oh, did you do some research to find that out?
No, you printed out an email and gave it to me.
God, you and can never be a
I just want to point out before we begin that sexy looking beard on the left. Look at that beast. That is luxurious right there. He's awesome. I can look at this entire poster right now and tell you he's the anchor of the team right there.
He's probably the most interesting one.
If you need like a tree cut down or a beer open that's not a twist off.
Or a bear skinned.
Yeah, or a bear skinned or to climb a mountain, he's your man right there. He's like at the anchor. Yeah.
He probably has jumper cables on him at all times.
How about the guy laying down? He looks very comfortable.
Can I just say that Zuby has
the look in his eyes is questionable,
fireplace.
Though.
He's laying down in front of a fireplace. Yeah.
Now, Zuby actually has a printout of information about this team that probably has more information than us just depicting their picture apart.
Okay. So, you want to read it now? That's okay. This is the team I'm on. I'm the one in the middle with the skull mask.
Oh.
Is that because he's fugly? Oh, who knows?
A mask.
We are a scenario slash woods ball team from West Palm Beach, Florida. Huh. Our home is Hot Shots Paintball Airsoft Field in... Loxachetti? How do you say that?
Just add a nest to it.
Loxachetti's, Florida.
There you go.
The team was formed over 2 years ago and had only 5 members. Now the team has 21 members and one awesome beard and still growing. We have been to scenario events like Wayne's World and General's Cup in
Wayne's
Florida.
Wayne's World.
And hope to travel outside of the state for scenario events throughout the U.S., this year, we created a new section of the team called Renegades Special Operations Force. That's where the beard came from.
Yes, that's
they
right.
got a Spec Ops Force. Yeah. Yep. The RSOF has 7 members and 1 sexy beard, and it is in the team Special Forces. We are trained in military tactics and deal with high-risk missions, VIP escorts, recon, etc. scenario events. We wear camouflage pattern uniforms instead of the team's jerseys.
Good for
photo
you guys.
Photo and JPEGs attached. Oh, sorry. That's for you, Todd.
Yep. Got him. Very cool.
Yes, very nice. Very nice beard. Oh, look at there's the Spec Ups guys right there in their Tiger
Spec
Stripe.
Spec Ups wear.
Yeah.
At which, by the way, incidentally, Tiger Stripe, sexiest camo, second sexiest camo you can possibly
What is the first sexiest?
All-terrain Tiger
Stripe.
Oh,
all-terrain Tiger Stripe.
I like the multicam.
It's like all the goodness of multicam with the sexiness of Tiger Stripe.
Uh-huh. Todd likes multicam. The Vault is sponsored by Tippmann. Pew, 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 pew.
Hi, guys. Joe from Flaggers Paintball. You're watching Behind the Bunker. Each week we go back in time. We do a segment called From the Vault. This week is no different. This is our first real game of the season at the outdoor field. And with that, you get old school stuff. People come out from the middle of nowhere and they bring things that are old. The newest thing on this is this second generation All-American smart parts, barrel now GOG. It's got a Freak front end. It's got a JT Revolution loader. I believe this is the second generation of the Revolution. It's got a Lapco feed neck. It's got Empire grips. This thing is so ancient and so old that people are using Motorola flip phones, and it's got a drop forward and a CP on off. Pretty crazy. This is Jordan's gun. He's from Cambridge, Ontario, and you're watching Behind the Bunker. Pew, pew.
Pew, pew, pew. All right. Very good. If you guys have any ideas of something that from the vault that Joe should do, send him an email vault to show at behindthebunker.com. Or you know what? Stop being lazy at home. Get off your damn ass. Grab a camera and do one yourself.
Yeah, yo, send it's 2 a.m. What are you doing with your life?
Sign up for Everest College.
Yeah. I did that with
DeVry. You can become any of the following in 6 weeks. A PSW, dental assistant, a welder, DeVry. And
Everest College. I want some real world experience at Comerica.
Making bladders for oil tankers.
Now you're talking.
Very nice.
Giddy up.
So, guys, we're going to move right into our live podcast. If you guys are watching us live, don't go anywhere. If you're watching us on YouTube, thank you for joining us. My name is Todd Ansich. I've been your host for this abomination with my friend Josh Zubizabrikas. Thank you for being.
Stay tuned for the after show where we undo our pants and let it all out.
Nice. Joe Kimson.
We're wearing pants.
From Flats Radius Paintball.
Hey, you're ahead of us.
Joe?
Joe? Yes, no, good.
Joe. All right, and thank you to our production booth, Seb and Matt, for pushing all the buttons properly this evening.
Yeah.
Very good. At least they're plugged into the right sockets this week. And Dusty.
Yeah.
Sorry?
Yeah.
Just as we were complimenting these guys on such a great job.
Yeah, I've had nothing in my headphones all night, so...
Well, there's nothing between your headphones.
Maybe that's the problem.
Very nice. All right, guys. So thank you very much for watching. We will see you back next week.
Nice. I'm Joe. Pew, pew. Thanks.
Josh Zubizabrikas. These pretzels are making Zoo thirsty.
Gavin from TerraTech Industries.
Hey, this is Matt the Grip, and you should be watching Wi-Fi Over.
I'm Dustin, king of the airwaves.
Hello, la la la.
Hello.
Sup?
Hey, guys, and welcome. This is our podcast. This is episode number 22 if you're listening and following along at home. Or if you're like me, it's Wednesday morning and you're driving to work and you just noticed that you had a new notification on your phone that says, hey, you have a new podcast. So I excitedly open it up and listen to this dribble. So thank you very much for tuning in.
Dribble? Dribble? There's a V in there.
Drool.
If it was said, there'd be dribbles.
Dribbles.
Dribbles. So thank you very much for joining us. My name is Todd Ansich. I'm your host again. With me is Josh Zubizabrikas.
Hey, that's me.
I like how you took your voice up an octave there.
Yeah.
So if you're messing around with the treble in your vehicle, leave it alone. There you go. Yeah. And Joe Kimson from Flats Radius Paintball.
Greetings. How are you?
Very nice.
Did you say Flats Radius?
Flats Radius. That's we won't get into how that came about, but we have
I'll tell you later.
We have Seb.
Hello.
How are you?
Good. You?
Good. Seb's doing all of our audio this evening, as well as asking some of our questions. And we have Matt, the crypt pushing all the buttons tonight.
Yeah, you really had a difficult time getting
it. I need some more wine to loosen up the tongue. And then, speaking of loose tongues, Dusty.
Yeah.
Thank you for being back in the program
Dustin
again.
Dustin Schnitzel. Yeah,
sure. Glad to be here.
Yeah, now we're all excited.
To the ladies,
because,
he's known as Trusty Rusty.
Wait, what?
Rusty from...
Nice. So guys, we have lots of your questions loaded in the program. We're watching the chat form. If you have any questions, get it up in the chat, or you can hit us up on Behind the Bunker on Twitter. Also, our Skype is live, and if we feel so inclined, we may take some of your Skype calls tonight. We are at Behind the Bunker on Skype. If you're not already on our address book, hit us up. So we just finished off having what would officially be in our neck of the woods the first outdoor weekend of the season. We had a recreational game on Saturday, and we had a paint fest game on Sunday, which we hosted, that had free entry, free rentals, cheap paint, just to get people to remember that there's paintball outside.
But we had product demos from Empire. We had a Defender, a Vanquish, a Cocker, a TM15, Splatmaster. Then we had the Eclipse out with an Etha. Then we had I don't think Tiberius had anything yet because they're working on it. But the guys from Milsig came up with the M17s and a bunch of different variants. Nice. Very cool.
And don't forget the fellers from Killhouse.
Tipman up as well. Tipman had several different markers out. X7 Phenom, FT12, A5, TPX, and then the Killhouse guys had all their variants as well.
Yeah, it was great. Cool. So thanks to those guys that came out. Thanks for listening tonight, and thank you for all that help. So that got us all in the mood. We're now in a new groove, and we're excited for the season.
Paintball mode.
Now, I will apologize for those of you that follow us on iTunes and Podomatic under the podcast. We do not have Jamie King on tonight. Unfortunately, he is not feeling well. He
ate too many cupcakes.
He choked on a poem.
I believe he's got the bronchitis.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
Well, apparently he does. So he's not in tonight, thus no poem tonight. So half the chat forum is going to be screaming, yay, no poem. And the other half are going to be screaming, what? That's the best part of the show.
Oh, Lord, it's a fire.
People give me emails saying they love it, and other people just hate it. I've never had something on our show that's been both loved and despised from both ends of the spectrum. But
what about Snarky?
Ah, that's true. Snarky was pretty upset some people, that's for sure. So again, we got tons of your questions to get to tonight. Who's reading them over there? Is Dusty getting them?
Question time.
I have them at the moment.
Let's go.
Sure.
All right, man. Airboy, who is in the chats, wondering what are your suggestions about starting a new paintball team?
Sorry, who's that from?
Airboy. He's in the chat right now.
Okay, very cool.
He just asked that question.
And what was his question?
Hi, welcome to this is Behind the Bunker. We do a live podcast that you're involved in.
Sorry.
You're actually sitting here?
Sorry, not only am I... I'm pretending I'm at a drive-through window and it was my time to order.
And you're oblivious.
So I missed it.
And you're telling us you didn't.
So he's wondering, what are your suggestions about starting a paintball team?
Don't.
What kind of team? A speedball?
There's so many already.
Speedball or a scenario team? We're not going to call it woods ball because that doesn't exist.
Yeah. You know what? If you're going to start I'll start with a speedball team just because I've had experience with that. Whatever you do with your team, make sure you bring people on that are people that you would want to be around. If someone annoys you in the least, don't bring them in. You're going to be spending an awful lot of time with these people, traveling, hotels, paintball matches. So make sure it's people that you like to be around, even if they may not have the best skill at the time. That comes with time. Make sure that you're a happy camper, because guys that get along on a team will stay together longer, and that's what makes a good team.
There are currently four of us on the team, and since we are only 16 of 17, we're 16 or 17.
Yeah.
Okay. We don't want people much older or younger.
You know, that's kind of limiting your options. You know, Airboy, you got to open up your horizons there, because you guys are great at 16 and 17, and that's great. But if you bring a couple of guys that maybe are a little older, that have been around the circuit a little bit more, have some experience.
Ew, and it's MagFed.
They might give you guys some tips, things that you guys have never seen before that will speed up your training. Especially with any team I've ever been on, if we bring in a new player from another camp, first thing we usually do is talk to them and find out, you know, what sort of skills do they bring to the team? What sort of things do they do that we maybe didn't, that we should look at? And we learn a few things and maybe adopt some of the things that they did.
It also takes a lot of time and patience.
That's true.
Yeah.
If you want to go the road of being, you know, a sponsored team and all that, then you have to build up a name for yourselves. You have to play frequent games, and you have to be willing to do stuff at your local field and continue on through that. But
yeah,
and I've got a lot of work ahead of you.
I'm not sure who brought Fisher 22 in the chat forum, right? And girlfriends. Make sure whoever you bring onto the team doesn't have girlfriends.
Make sure they don't want one. They don't
have girlfriends.
Yeah,
yeah. Because as soon as they get a girlfriend, they disappear.
They're gone.
Yeah,
exactly. Yeah, very good. So, so just funny. Be open-minded for sure. Just be open-minded.
It's like Seb when he's playing Titanfall. Hang on, my girlfriend's there.
I gotta go. That's why the village people lasted so long.
She will kick you in the nuts next time.
She probably will.
Yes.
I will give.
Man, everybody's bashing the MagFed, eh? C4 explosives. MagFeds have girlfriends. What?
As they should. Silly.
Well, you don't ever hear an airsofter with a girlfriend, right?
MagFed's another genre of paintball, guys. It's not going to go anywhere. Yeah. It's here to stay, and it's going to coexist. You're going to have speedball in the speedball fields. You're going to have recreational paintball in the recreational field. You're going to have scenario guys doing scenario stuff. You're going to have airsoft on one field, and you're going to have MagFed guys doing their thing. Low cap games.
You will, Joe, but it's a gateway to stupidity known as first strike rounds.
Would you adopt MagFed more if you knew that the people playing MagFed were not using first strikes?
Absolutely.
Okay. No Clue 119 in the chat says that Airboy, you need to find someone rich to pay all your bills. That's another thing when you're making a team. Make sure they all have jobs or the ability to keep a job.
Yeah,
or cars. Sugar mama. Go find a MILF.
So get a rich girlfriend.
Yeah.
Yeah, but then you won't be allowed
or
to
Or boyfriend
play.
If that's your thing, you know. That, dude.
Well, not that there's anything wrong with that. All right.
Just don't tell
Next
anybody.
Question, Dusty.
Eddie, he emailed us in. He's saying,
what did he say?
I've been playing for 3 years. Since then, I must have spent a good $8,000 in the sport between playing and purchasing my DM12 and DAM. And I'm constantly purchasing things every time I get on companies' websites. Who else has this problem?
Yeah, you're talking to seven people that have that problem right now in the studio.
Shouldn't have bought a damn.
Six people,
big
rather. You know what? Paintball is, if you like toys, paintball is a great sport for you. I mean, I also, you know, Seb and I both are audiophiles.
Seb.
We're constantly buying cameras and microphones and all kinds of stuff. So, you know, just because you're doing it in paintball doesn't mean you necessarily have a problem.
In other sports, if you were in motocross, you'd probably buy a new bike every year, and you'd buy all kinds of equipment every year. And if you were a skier, you'd probably maybe buy skis every couple of years, new boots, bindings, new gear. It's just like any sport, golf, hockey, whatever. Yeah. It's a sport you've chosen to sport.
Yeah, I'm a big advocate of buying new things until you find what's right. But once you find something that you like, stick with it for a little while so you can learn on it.
Or hoard it.
Go straight up to the top.
To hoarding.
Buy yourself a Resurrection Auto Cocker. the resurgent of the Revy.
The Revolution. I have a prophecy on mine.
Get yourself the brand new Ninja Tank. And then that's all you need.
Now, you guys brought up a good point.
And batteries.
When you purchase gear, one of the things, now I know not everybody can do this because everyone's on a budget, but if you can at all help it, never ever sell any of your gear. And I say that because there's so many guns out there that there's two of them that I let go and I want them back. And I wish, you know, I've never sold any of my goggles. Oh, I've never
exactly
sold anything.
There's a couple guns that I wish I had that I sold.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. Like I sold what? Mark 1 Uzi, my green Bushmaster with a matching 7 ounce tank and a lever quick change, and then I had a Model 85 I should have kept.
So if you can't afford to do that, then just really consider getting rid of your equipment when you do, if you actually are going to not like it. If you're getting rid of it because you ultimately hate it, then fine, but if you like it and you just want something better, you're getting rid of it for the wrong reason.
Yeah, you can just go ahead and sell your Evil Omen now.
No!
Kablam!
I'm sorry. There are some people out there who collect classic failures.
Yeah. Oh, I have an omen.
That's true.
God has an omen.
It's like the women that date Dusty, right?
Ouch.
I'm just kidding.
Cure Bob had an interesting question. How do you, kind of in the same vein, how do you persuade a field owner to lean towards MagFed or pump days? Why not, your field owner has more than one playing field, most fields have a couple anyway, let the alternate the fields, have one go on, one go off, or whatever.
What you need to do, Kirby Bob, is go out, get five or six of your friends, go to the field and say, can we play? And he'll see you guys there as a tangible market and tell him that we're going to start inviting more people. And once you start bringing some numbers, he will put you up there in his priority list.
Where are you located, Cure Bob, or Curvy Bob, as Todd called you?
I read it as Kirby Bob.
Kirby Bob.
Kirby Bob's.
Yeah. All right.
Carlos. Jesus. Omen backwards is Nemo.
Thank you, Carlos. Juan Carlos, kitty, yes. Kitty, kitty.
Both their mothers died. All right. Do we have any more questions?
Yeah. Brent Pritchard wonders, dwell. Do you leave it alone or do you play around with it?
I really don't want to dwell on that. We'll go on a different question.
It depends. it depends. This question's for Seb, but I think I think Seb. We should ask Sam. Seb.
Sam.
Do you change the dwell?
I would suggest leaving the dwell as is. Yep. Because you'll have to deal with a first shot drop off, which is, you always see the pros taking a couple shots before they do their break off. That's because their dwell is very low. So you don't want to dwell too much in the dwelling settings.
You know what? The dwell is in your gun set at the factory for what it should be. And if it was supposed to be changed, it would be changed for that. If your gun is not working properly, reset the dwell to what it's supposed to be. There are very few guns out there where you can actually take it out of the box, change the dwell, you know, to customize it for it to actually work properly. I
set my 98 dwell on my Tippmann 98, and it worked good.
Let me put it this way. You will run out of paint before you run out of air, especially with that new Ninja tank that's super light. Is this 45-45 or 68-45?
It's a 68-45, but in a 45-45 container. It's pretty small. Azubi, he likes it. Yes. I was ramping.
I'm still waiting for Joe to...
Well, you know what? I'm waiting on them to be TC approved. It's got Jack. If we can move to the States, and I'll get all of them that you want. But if you want to have one here that you can fill.
Yeah, I know.
So don't touch your dwell. Leave it alone. You're fine. Okay. You're fine.
Don't touch it. Don't touch it.
Next.
No bada touch.
All right. The next question I have is from SPECTER. Spay sitter. I don't know how to say that. As far as air tank safety goes, how do you get over a mild fear? Recently occurring fear of tank-related accidents. Have you ever seen a tank-related accident?
Arnold Schwarzenegger has this video that he drives over stuff with a tank.
Joe put the wrong O-ring in my tank one time.
Did he?
Yeah.
I did. A fill nipple O-ring?
In a fill nipple.
Here's the thing. Okay. Tanks are very dangerous. They are filled with high-pressure air, and they are explosive if they're messed around with.
Making tank
However, if you actually take a cross-section of a tank and see how thick the walls are, you shouldn't have to. You should be worried about it exploding. The safety valves on your gun are set at a safe level, so if your reg sticks or if you overfill your tank, it's going to blow off those safety rupture discs and not actually shoot anything out. It's just going to shoot the air out. It'll be loud. It'll scare you, but it's not going to harm you. The threads on your reg that are screwed into your tank, if you start backing it out slowly and unscrewing it, you'll notice that about halfway, there's a little notch cut in it so that if the tank and reg starts to separate, when it gets about a quarter of the way out, it starts evacuating air so it won't turn into a projectile. So there's so many safety facets on that. Now, I'm not going to say that there's never been an accident in tank history, but if you do not mess with your tank, you let a certified airsmith deal with it, and you purchase a new tank and fill it with a proper fill station, you should never, ever, ever have a problem. I can't say you're never going to have a problem.
Any tank you buy will have a hydro test date on it, much like a propane cylinder you use for barbecuing or cookouts. That's an American term. Yeah. They expire and they just have to be rehydrated, and you can usually do that at a fire station, a fire extinguisher facility.
Yep.
Yeah. Have you seen the video of the guy that dives into the snake and blows the tank off?
Yeah. All right, so forget everything I said. Dustin just now made you nervous.
Thanks, great. It's true. It happens.
Killjoy.
We were sitting on the couch and we were getting somewhere with our patient there, but
all right, whatever.
Let's get another question going.
It's a lot more HPA is a lot more stable than CO2.
Yeah,
for agreed. Sure. Yep. And proven, sir.
Yep.
Technologies.
All right. Why do you think paintball is getting so much smaller? Like the actual paintballs in general.
Maybe you're just getting bigger. Ever think of that?
I don't know. Maybe.
Maybe put down the snack bowl at the end of the day.
Wow.
I don't know.
Is this Ride Dusty hour?
Yeah.
I believe it's manufacturing costs. If they can shave a thou or two thou off the size of a paintball, when they start making, when you're talking billions and billions of paintballs, they're saving a lot of money. Just think if your main staple in life is making Rice Krispie Squares. And if you made Rice Krispie Squares for your entire life, 7 days a week, 24 hours a day, and if you each tray of Rice Krispie Squares, you kept out two or three Rice Krispies, how many Rice Krispies you'd have at the end.
Seven.
Think of your saving.
Matt Bishop wrote, he added in on the comments, cheaper to produce, packs into smaller boxes, which are cheaper to buy, fits more boxes on a truck, what's cheaper to ship?
Okay, but you got to realize you're still dealing with 6-8 cal roughly, even though they're making the paintball smaller. We're talking microns. We're talking small, very hard to measure sizes.
One hundredth of an inch.
Yeah,
yeah, so that's a micron.
One hundredth of an inch. 2 or 3 Rice Krispie squares per Rice Krispie tray.
What?
No, I wouldn't even say that. That's not Rice Krispies, I would say.
Rice Krispies, yes, the unit.
Yeah.
Oh, unit of crispy.
Like a snap or a crackle. You know?
Snap, crackle, or a pop.
Okay. Now that you've said that, Joel, but coming from a manufacturing background, I find it very, very hard to believe the reason why that's happening is a cost thing. I can't see them sitting in a marketing meeting or a production meeting and going, you know, if we shaved 1/100th off the shell size on our paintball, we're going to save $57 this year. I highly doubt.
I think the conversation actually did happen, but they used the increments of measurements of crispies. So it's 1/1 crispieth.
If anything, I would venture to say that somehow, somewhere, the formula for the shell that they're using changed.
No, they use dies.
Well, yeah, but I think to remake an entire die 1/1000th of an inch smaller.
Eventually they wear out.
You're talking, yeah.
It would make it bigger, would it not?
Yeah. It's going to make it bigger.
I would predict that they're using the same 6-8 cal molds. They're just maybe not filling it as, they're not topping up as much as it maybe once was.
Maybe it's because of the exchange on the dollar.
We're talking minuscule amounts here, right?
If anything, I would say that the speed in which they're manufacturing them has increased.
Yep.
And their machinery is not keeping up with the production levels they're talking about.
Yes, buddy.
And I think that's what's happening. Anyways.
Yep.
My background tells me that's exactly.
You got me at Woods Ball.
All right.
All right, I have a question here from Corey Verbust. What's the purpose of the porting on the barrel? Is it just for sound control, or is it make it easier on the paint? Is there any other reason?
Would you guys mind if we leave this question and we'll come back to it next week? I had a barrel expert set to call in tonight to deal with that question, and I think he's going to come in next week instead. So let's leave that. I've got a barrel expert that's going to answer that next week. Can we circle back, put a pin in it, as Matt said last week or the other week?
So tune in everybody next week to listen to the barrel expert talk about porting and
honing
and barreling.
Yep.
Along.
All right, Miles Saucier writes in, I have to ask the age-long paintball question. Playing paintball at a younger age, it's hardest to have a job because the only time you can work is the weekends, and that's when you want to play paintball. Any advice for younger players 12 to 18?
Ooh. Well, first of all, you don't need to play paintball every Saturday and Sunday. Unless you want to take it up competitively in practice. The other option is to take your Saturdays and Sundays and donate them to a paintball field, work for them, and in turn turn that proceed into some paint, because that's probably the cheapest, most effective way.
I don't know how often refs or staff at a paintball field actually get to play, though.
Tuesday nights.
That's true.
Many fields are recognizing this fact that people work a lot, so some fields will stay open later one evening. Some will open maybe a midweek game, and if there's an indoor field near you, then they're.
But let's say some kid came up to you and wanted to know that, hey, if you were going to clean the staging area in the morning and clean it up at night at the end of the day, would you donate him a bag of paint? A small bag of paint? Sure, right?
Sure.
If you can convince a field owner to do that, there you go. You're at the field anyways. If you go in above, have a shorter day of play, use the paint that he gives you and work it off that way, and you can set up a rapport and a relationship with him, that would be the best way.
But that's still not answering his question. Where is the income coming from? Where's the tangible money?
He wants money. He's got to do other stuff too, Todd. He can't just...
Well, yeah, but he can sell his soul elsewhere.
Well, let's use paintball to teach you a very, very important lesson in life. You're going to have to work for money if you want to do something, period. It's not like, unless you're willing to sacrifice a little bit of time to have a job, you're not going to be able to play. So sad, but that's the way life is.
See, now next thing you're going to do is say, I'm going to need money to have a girlfriend.
Yeah. You might want to start saving up for that one right now.
Got a bank loan. Yeah, line of credit.
Take a line of credit out.
Sell some organs.
Yeah. But what I'm saying is work at a tangible place on a Saturday, and on a Sunday go to the paintball field, donate your time and trade it in for cash, and then you're win.
It never hurts to ask.
I have a really good question here from Charlie Decker. He writes in, what is the best age you should start to allow and train your child to respect the sport of paintball? And if they know the rules and the safety of the sport at a young age, between 7 and 10, should they be allowed to participate at a local field?
Splatmaster Night. Splatmaster. Exactly what it's for.
We have a Splatmaster Night coming up Thursday night at the indoor from 5 till 9:30 at
Buckets.
The Flaggers Indoor. Buckets of fun.
I think 8's a great age for Splatmaster. I think anything younger than that, they're not able to hold the gun proficiently and cock them. I mean, even at 8, a lot of kids don't have the muscles for that. So although you're eager to get your small people into it, I would say 8's probably the cutoff. And even 8's pretty young. There's some 8-year-olds still going on 6. I don't know. 8's good, but real traditional paintball, as soon as they're 10 and as soon as they're old enough to understand and have the strength to do that, I would get them out to the paintball field right away. Absolutely. Yeah.
I agree.
Yeah, I wish I started at 10.
It wasn't invented when I was 10.
Nor was color TV. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding.
Maybe not.
I don't remember. I was young, he says.
Yeah, all right.
I know it was.
Mitchell Keel's wondering, what do you guys think? The FX adapter kit or dual-wielding pistols?
Sorry, repeat the question. Dual-wielding pistols or?
Or what should he do? Dual-wield pistols or FX adapter kit?
Which one's the FX?
What's an FX adapter kit? Research department.
It's like the Sarge kit, but it's from Milsig? It's like the Sarge kit. Your pistol goes into it and it makes it into a pistol.
If you're going to do double pistols, you have to make sure that you train shooting them sideways. Like gangster style. You know what? Don't use two guns at the same time. You have a hard enough time aiming one. I don't know how you're going to aim both shooting. I don't know.
Yeah, how do
whatever happened to just playing paintball?
Hey,
why is this a thing?
It depends on how egg you want to look.
Yeah.
Scrambled.
Egg is speedball, isn't it?
You can look egg all you want, but
everyone that's out on the field, if you're running around with those in your egg, you might get egg on your face.
Enjoyed an egg white omelet this morning. Can we get back to Kirby Bob's question in the chat? He says, I've heard of recycled paintballs. What are they?
Bad idea.
Now, recycled paintball guys, there's no such thing as recycled paintballs. There's recycled shell paintballs, where they take the leftover trimmings that has gone through the machine, grind them up again, and reuse them. That's usually in a lower grade paint.
That's on a lot of pharmaceutical companies. Some of the paintball manufacturers take clippings from Contact C capsules, Robitussin, any gelatin capsule, and it's virgin fill. It's just been recycled and ground up and then remelted, and it goes into a lower grade paintball. But in most cases, several manufacturers, the paint is still quite round. It's just a different shell configuration. Yeah. It's not virgin pet gel, as they call it.
Now, APC in the chat wants to know, he says, Joe, can you tell us anything about the Shoreline game?
Todd, can you say anything?
Well, first of all, let's tell people what the Shoreline game is for those people that may not know.
Do you want me to tell?
Yeah, absolutely.
Shoreline, for anyone that doesn't know, Tim Barnett is Shoreline Paintball, and he's in Britain, but he's branched from Britain into Europe, and he is probably Europe's biggest promoter of scenario and big games in the European Union, if you will. He's never ventured into the Americas, be it North or South America. So his first game off the British and off the European continent is going to be on Sunday, September the 21st. It's going to be at Flag Raiders Paintball in Kitchener, Ontario, and it will be a genuine Shoreline game.
Yeah. Now, more information. There was a teaser poster with the date and the location announced last week.
The Shoreline 1 game. It's the one to go to, the one you don't want to miss, the first one.
Yeah, and there'll be more information about that and a website and stuff coming very, very, very soon. So stay tuned for that. All right. Couple more questions to get to, Dusty.
Yeah, Nick Castillo writes in, how does it make you feel when someone wipes a hit and you see it?
I feel the same way I always do. Kaz, get off the field. Oh, did I say that loud?
Jesus. You know what? It's twofold. If you're playing in speedball and if you see a guy wipe and he gets away with it, good for him, I guess. If he's playing rec ball, that's a pretty yeah, low thing to do. I mean, I would call him on it, because that's a pretty low form of cheating. You can be cocky and say, yeah, I get to shoot him again, but it's still a pain in your side if you shoot the guy, you do well, and he wipes it and continues to play.
I've been playing against little kids on their birthday party and stuff like that. Yes, because I'm a paintball bully.
Him and Matt have started their own team. It's called the Newbie Hunters.
Whatever. Anyway, you're not necessarily a little kid, and you're playing against somebody, and you hit them, and you just tell them to wipe it off and keep playing because it's that, I've done that before, or you know, just carry on.
Yeah. Yep.
Wow.
Yep. I wonder if you'll be able to hear Dustin that in the podcast. All right. Cool. So we got time for a couple more questions. Dusty, how many have we gotten through all of the questions tonight, or do you still have a stack?
I have some. Yeah, I got quite a few.
Good,
yeah.
Dusty. That's your.
I'm running out of good ones, but I do have a few.
Dusty, it almost looks like you're with the black hoodie and the white background. It almost looks great, like your head's floating. Like you're not even a body. It's just your head.
And the hat's black, too.
And the hat's black. Everything's black.
I miss his mustache.
Back in black.
Well, which one? Like dirty stash or like when I had a nice trimmed goatee?
Dirty stash was kind of nice. Yeah. All right.
All right. Connor Baker writes in, I am 6'3" and realize that bunkers are getting smaller and smaller. Do you think eventually there will be a status quo for paintball? Also, do you prefer on turf or grass?
Yeah. Let's answer the second question first, the second part of that question first. I like turf, but I prefer grass. I like the varying terrain of the grass. I like how you can slide on certain parts where you need to. Corners are a little roughed up, so they're a little easier for traction, you know, for running out. But
there's nothing better than watching grass seeds blooming
photosynthesis
in the spring air. The turf just sits there and just turf just sits there idly, and grass goes bloom, yeah. And it attracts bees. Next one. What's the other half of that question, Dustin? I think if this your problem of being 6'3" and the bunker's getting smaller, that could be addressed by the paintball manufacturers making a slightly larger paintball.
How would that help?
But grass,
a 6'8" ball. Yeah.
But grass on a speedball field, by the time you play the finals, if you make it, not that I would know what I'm talking about here, but at the end of the weekend, that field, whatever people slide, is usually there's no more grass there. It's just a mudslider.
Yeah.
On turf, on the other end, I would say that it's pretty equal. Like the
yes, but I've seen turf fields though to combat that where people have slid so much that the turf has shifted, and then it becomes warbly with those little ripples and
like
stuff.
Like when
and then
your socks
slide
fall
anyways.
Down.
Yeah. So you're right. Like a pristine grass field versus a pristine turf field, I'd still take grass over it. But both fields have their problems.
So the moral of the story is every speedball field is a wasted scenario field.
In answer to the question about bunkers shrinking and standards, there is very few standards.
I was in a pool.
Bunker shrinking.
Bunkers shrinking. Children singing.
Should have bought air-ups.
Yeah, there's very few standards in paintball, guys. Aside from the size of the guns and the tank ratings, I mean, everything changes. I mean, they can't consistently keep a rate of fire for more than a year or two before they change it, and they're changing bunker shapes every year. So it's going to be a while till you see anything standard in speedball, I hate to say it.
The field sizes are standard for the most part.
Yeah. But the PSP changed it 2 years ago. They made it longer, and then they reneged
and
went back to
regular
size.
They've standardized the covering, be it grass or turf as well.
Yeah, I guess. Well, you don't see too many gravel fields.
Yeah.
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 I like cookies.
I like turtles.
I like bear paws.
I like turtles.
Bear paws are the
best. I like turtles. Next.
Oh,
Greg Hastings right in. He said, when will the manufacturers, fields, etc. organize a single effort to help promote our sport?
In an ideal world, that would happen, but I don't see that ever happening.
I don't think so. Thank you, young Gregory Hastings.
I hear he's a new up-and-coming paintball player.
Maybe.
He's from New Jersey, isn't he? Doesn't he have a Jeep?
New Jersey.
We need to get a research department on it. Greg, if you're listening, we want to know if you have a Jeep in New Jersey.
I read about him in an issue of Faceful published in 2003.
This guy's own video game. Or a few.
I think he was in the Navy.
Wow, did we railroad this pretty quick. Looking at the time, I think we got a couple more minutes. Here's what I want to do for the next one. We're every week on the podcast, we like to answer a question before it even happens. Last week I promised I want to give the guys in the chat, the live chat, an opportunity to submit one answer. And we're going to wait till you guys get your answers in. And then we'll read the question. But what the premise is, guys, is that we want you to pre-answer a question. We're not going to tell you what it is. We just want your answer and see if you've answered the right question.
What will the person that gets the closest answer will get free entry to the Trek Wars game at Flag Raiders on April 27th.
And if you can't make it, you get a hearty handshake or a high
you get
five.
We'll all wave
virtual
at you.
High five.
We'll mail you a hug.
Very good. So let's hit a question up before we give the actual question away for that contest.
So everybody answer their question.
Just
or
pick
not.
Just pick one at random and then don't ask it yet.
Oh, so I'm not supposed to ask? I'm confused.
No, they're gonna answer. It's like Jeopardy. They're gonna everyone's gonna pre-answer their question and they're gonna type it into the. Yeah. Into the forum.
But while we're
Centurion,
waiting.
Strike him.
Now, while we're waiting for that question to be asked, let's ask another one because it takes a little bit of time for the guys in the live chat to get their
stuff
in.
Here we go. No clue said Autococker. Okay.
Autococker.
Autococker. Autococker.
Yeah. All right. So let's ask
aluminium.
A question.
All right. Chris Maverick writes in, I have a question for next week's show. What qualities make paintball personalities appealing to you? Their videos, their interactive shows, their reviews, their personality, how they interact with you in person or in events, or their character. I think it will be a good conversation starter, I think, and give out audience an opportunity to see who else is bringing us info on paintball to strengthen networks. Yeah. Hope mine gets picked as a question. Keep up the good work, guys.
Well, he said for next week, so let's leave that on the docket
for next week.
That was a pretty good question, though.
So far we've got answers of Autococker, Microfibers.
Airboy doesn't understand.
The one on the right.
Yeah.
Airboy, you have to answer. We're going to... Dustin,
no, that's his answer.
Oh, he doesn't understand.
Okay, very good.
What is a fresh squeegee? That's right. Fine. Thank you, Airboy.
Very good. So what
okay, speedball. Speed there we ball. Go.
So again, the premise for those of you that are listening at home, we are going to ask a question in a moment. But before we do that, we're going to pre-answer the question and see who gets the closest to the actual question. Fisher22 says Empire.
That's close.
What do you mean it's close? How do you know? Do you have a question picked out already?
I just asked.
Oh,
no, but we haven't asked the question yet.
We haven't answered the question yet.
Yeah.
It's like giving
okay,
us
let's
a clue
answer. We'll answer our question.
Okay, you go first. I would like to go last this week. I was listening to the podcast this week, and I heard this segment, and I actually had an answer. I'm trying to remember what it was because I thought it was a clever one. And of course, I've lost it now.
I wrote five answers down, and they're in the car.
All right.
Joe, you're up.
Epic failure.
All right. Okay.
Okay. I will say that I wear a Shema to offers the best protection.
I'm gonna say you don't need to lube and oil your gun every single week. Just do what the manufacturer suggests, and maybe just do an external wipe down.
I'm gonna say save your money, buy the Resurrection Auto Cocker because it comes with a barrel kit as well.
Okay.
Two hits in the chat says liquor and whores. I don't think that's the right answer,
somebody's
but I haven't heard the question yet.
Boys.
Guest 643 says slick.
Make sure you wear a barrel
lube.
Condom if you're liquor and whores.
Or sleek lube. And
no comprende, Carlos.
Psycho Bear says always use lube on your gun. Dustin Slayer says the answer is yes. Bob Long is crazy. So let's hear what's the question, Dusty?
All right, Xavier Schultz writes in, I have a hard time picking out good starting equipment for the game. I already have a marker in mind and own one pod that was given to me and a JT full head paintball helmet. I'm looking to go cheap. What do you guys suggest?
Oh.
Boom.
No.
That just happened.
He just said,
that just happened.
He just said he wants to go cheap. We're talking like
and
50
I
bucks.
And I said, save your money.
Yes, you did.
Yeah. Get the Resurrection Auto Cocker.
All right. For the first time on this crazy show, we actually got an answer correct, and I will give
okay,
Zuby point
so
number one.
Okay, so now in the forum, who is?
I don't think anybody got
Empire. No clue. 119 said autococker.
Or microfibers.
Airboy says I don't understand.
But microfiber is not going to help you sling paint downfield.
That's true.
Yeah. You could use it as an old
Is there anyone below that?
No. No clue. Looks like a winner.
No clue. Whoever you are, we don't know because we have no clue. You are the winner of the free entry to Trek Wars at Flag Ritter's Paintball.
Very good.
So you'll have to contact somebody.
Contact Steve in our marketing department.
Steve.
Show up behind the bunker. No, yes, we said that. No clue. 119. Well, Zuby's not going to win.
Yeah. All right, guys. So this has been Behind the Bunker. I appreciate you guys listening to our podcast via Podomatic or iTunes, or if you're watching us live on a Monday night. Thank you very much. Thank you to our sponsors, Empire and JT, DLX, the manufacturers of Lux, Tippmann NGI, AirUps Bunker Systems, Valken, Patchworks, and Flag Raiders. Also, there's something in the works. We might see a new sponsor on that spot maybe as early as next week.
Sponsor a concert.
Stay tuned for that announcement.
Eric Angler.
No,
Angle
after what Customs. We did for Angel, you won't see Angel sponsoring our program for a while. So thank you very much for joining us, guys. We do really appreciate it. Thank you, Josh, for being in the podcast.
No, thank you, Todd.
And thank you for taking home the the at-home version of the show for winning.
Yeah, buddy.
Nice.
Joe?
Thank you very much for having me and all your submissions. And I'd like to give a shout-out to my friend Ying in Georgia, who listens to this on his podcast.
Nice. Now, here's a question.
Recently had a baby.
Last week at the end of the podcast, Joe left here and had to trek for 5 hours in his vehicle to head to do some errands. How many podcasts did you listen to?
I listened to one or two. Okay.
So if you have 5 hours to kill and nothing better to do, and you finally break down and listen to one or two podcasts, yeah, very good.
Listen to other stuff.
Dustin Schnitzelholst.
Yeah.
It was nice to have you back on the program.
Thanks. Nice to be here.
Next week, we'll get you set up so your research department computer works.
Yeah, and hopefully I won't be sick anymore.
Yep.
Yep, buddy.
Seb.
Hello. Bonjour.
Seb.
Joe.
Seb.
Todd.
Seb.
Thank you for being. How did the show sound tonight?
Okay. Except for Dusty.
We needed better talent, is what you're saying?
Ooh.
We need to implant the microphone into Dusty's mouth.
Hey, I'm not the one that's supposed to set this sound stuff up.
Dustin, I just want to put this out there. I spent a decent amount of money on my car audio to get the purest possible sound again. I'm not one of those, you know, thumping basses. I got 10 subs in the back of my car. Not one of those guys.
The system.
I like to listen to some high quality audio. Your ability to make my speakers pop on the podcast, wow. Unreal. Like popping and screeching because I swear that microphone was somewhere near the back of your tonsils.
Nice.
Whoa.
I'm not sure how Todd is in the chat right now. There's a Todd guest in the chat. He says, if you haven't done a shout out for Fernando Rios, congrats him on his new baby daughter. Well, there you go. There's a shout out for him and his new baby daughter. Matt, once you take the microphone out of Dusty's mouth, make sure we sanitize it for next week in case someone else needs it.
Well, that's not my department.
Maintenance staff.
Yeah, and I forgot to ask you, Matt, how's the numbers since we were running that camera?
Maxed out at like 55 to the... Yeah, good. Nothing major.
Good, awesome. So we have a new camera and a new system. That's great. Next week, hopefully we'll have a new audio system if Seb gets off his butt and gets it in.
Go.
Very good. Awesome, guys. Anyone have anything else to say before we head out?
Go play Titanfall when you're out playing paintball.
Send us your stuff.
Only on PC.
Costanza.
Very good. Thanks, guys, for watching. We will see you next week.
Auf Wiedersehen.